Hi, Annissa Coy here with Firehouse Education and this week's Ask Annissa video column. And this week the question that came in was, how do I find good employees for my cleaning business? There are several ways that you can find really good employees for your cleaning restoration business. And I'm gonna mostly speak to the fire side of things, but this also works when you're looking for, you know, the flux of labor that we need when we get into a lot of mitigation, water losses, that sort of thing as well. So what we do is I look for people who are obviously in other service-based businesses, people who have, you know, the good people skills, that sort of thing. We all know that. But the places to look for them that I have found really successful are, for instance, stay-at-home moms who want to work part-time or work some of the time full-time. They're a great resource. The other is college students. A lot of times during like college breaks or the summertime, they're looking for work. They're usually very eager, and I find that they do a really great job and they fall into the realm of cleaning really nicely. The other is retired people. Normally they come with a little bit more sense of responsibility. They've got great work ethics and they're not necessarily somebody that you need to keep busy full time if your cleaning side of your business has some ebb and flow to it, which is really beneficial. The other thing is when you're dealing with like cat loss type situations, which you could also do in a non-cat situation, but you can use a temp agency. Now, if you do that, I want to give you a little bit of caution there. What we do is, you know, temp agencies, they're obviously not certified and heavily trained in the kind of work that we do. But if you assign them with a good supervisor, someone very well trained in your company who can oversee the work and quality control that they're doing, they can be a really great resource, especially if you find yourself in need during a lot of claims that come in, or as I said, a cat loss type situation. The other thing that I want to talk about is actually having your current employees sending you other employees that would be a right fit for your company. It's one of the biggest ways, once we've established our crew, our core crew that we have, that we bring in new hires. We get our current staff members to refer friends, family, or people that they know that are looking for work that they feel would be a good right fit. Now, what's really important for this type of a scenario to be successful is for you to have a really good company culture in your business. You know, employees that are buying into your mission statement and the goals that you have, not only for your company, but for your team and your clients as well. So, you know, the employees that are really bought in, the good ones that you have on your current staff, they're not going to want to bring people in or recommend them that if they're not going to be a right fit. The other thing that we do is we actually give a referral reward, just like we do in our referral-based marketing programs, for employees who bring someone in that winds up staying with our company. Now, what we do is at the end of their 30-day probationary period that we have for all new employees, we then will pay the referring employee $100 for that referral. So that works out really nice and gives them a little bit of incentive. Now, finding employees for your cleaning business is obviously only one part of the equation. Once you've found those people, you've got to be sure that you've got a good, solid, as I said, company culture going in your business, and you need to have good training programs, not only inside your business, but that you can rely on outside of your business to be able to, you know, keep your employees informed, to make them feel a part of the bigger picture of everything and give them the tools, skills, and knowledge that they're going to need to be successful, because their success is obviously going to be your success. All right, well, I hope you found that video valuable and that answered your question. Please be sure to send me more, Annissa@firehouseeducation.com, and I just might answer your question on next week's Ask Annissa video column.